what's approaching, the supreme moment, reality striking closer than it seems, don't it?
Well, it's good. Hopefully everybody's doing well for the weekend. Time for another showcase. This is going to be the Paramount Saiyan, Super Saiyan God SS Goku or Super Saiyan Blue Goku. This is somewhat of an older unit, but I'm sure quite a few of you guys actually still use this unit on categories like Realm of Gods. It is still a pretty decent unit overall and can apply a good amount of damage on proper team setups. Let's go ahead and cover the stats a little bit. Leader skill is agility, strength, and physical types. HP and attack increase of 30%. Super attack will cause supreme damage to enemy. Passive skill is the godly eruption, attack increase of 100% when performing a super attack. Links include Super Saiyan, 10% increase to attack. Warrior Gods, 10% increase to attack. Kamehameha, 2500 to attack when SA is launched. Super God Combat, 15% increase to attack. Resurrection F, 700 increased attack, prepare for battle, plus 2 key, and finally Fierce Battle, attack increase of 15%. Falls into two categories, Realm of Gods and Pure Saiyans, and max stats are the following: HP of 13,713, attack of 13,544, defense of 9,517, 12 key multipliers, 140%. You will see the unit linked up with the Super Saiyan Blue Vegeta unit, the strength version, just because they do share quite a few links like Warrior Gods, Super God Combat, Resurrection F, and Fierce Battle. So that adds up very quickly to a pretty good attack boost overall. So like I said, this is a video with the unit pretty much on the Realm of Gods category. I'm sure the unit can do fine on a pure Saiyans or even a super type team. It really doesn't matter. I think probably outside of Realm of Gods, what you may face is certain key links that are going to be missing within, you know, pure Saiyans or super types. You might have to force in Realm of Gods category type units just to, you know, provide better links overall, like Warrior Gods or Super God Combat, or even Resurrection F. But regardless, this unit's not bad. It's actually pretty decent for such an old unit. And I don't know, I think, you know, nowadays it might be out of the limelight a little bit compared to the strength version of the Super Saiyan, you know, God SS Goku or Super Saiyan Blue Goku, whatever you want to call it. But in terms of, you know, the passive skill for the strength version has an attack and defense increase of 90%, and then plus an additional attack increase of 50% when facing two or more enemies. So overall, the strength version does have a greater balance and higher attack output versus the agility counterpart. But it would be interesting to see how the unit improves with the potential rebirth, or I guess they call it EZAs now, Extreme Z Awakened. So it'll be interesting to see when they actually improve this guy. I mean, you never know, because units like the Extreme Intelligence, Perfect Cell, that really nobody used, not only used, but not many, in my opinion, didn't invest the hidden potential orbs, you know, prior to finding out about the EZA. So you never know. This unit is definitely a decent option to max out on the potential system. He's not a bad unit overall. He's actually pretty decent. But you know, if you do have the strength version, that might be a better option overall in terms of balance. But the agility version is definitely a worthwhile unit as well. An attack increase of 100% as part of the passive is a pretty good boost overall, so you're not really going to struggle either with the key links in a Realm of Gods situation. Most of the units will, you know, link up together pretty well. You do have units like the Rose unit that do boost up the defense, so even if the defensive stats are somewhat lower in today's standard, you know, he could do just fine. So overall, not a bad unit. And again, the best units to link the agility version are units like the strength version of Super Saiyan Blue Vegeta and whatnot, just because there are, you know, units that have Super God Combat. I mean, that's a 15% increase in attack, and then Resurrection F, even though it's a pretty minor link of only 700 flat increase attack, you know, you could certainly think about certain units that provide a boost with the Super God Combat Link. I mean, for the most part, you will have units that share the Warrior God's Link skill in the Realm of God setting. Most units, you know, the better ones have Fierce Battle as well. So, and all of these units will have the Super Saiyan Link. So, even if you don't necessarily link the Agility Super Saiyan Blue Goku with the you know, strength counterpart or the physical type or the agility type, doesn't really matter, but you're only going to essentially miss out on 15% overall in attack. Everything else should apply for the rest of the team, so, you know, don't necessarily prioritize that. This is more or less a showcase video, so obviously you want to factor in every potential link skill that could be applied toward attack. The Strength Vegeta unit is actually pretty good too. The output's pretty amazing for that unit considering how old that unit actually is. I've seen the Strength Vegeta unit hit for up to about 1.4, 1.5 million in a good situation. So that unit is actually pretty good too. And I want to be honest with the Agility Goku unit. I think the base form card art is better looking than the TUR version. I don't know, in my opinion, it just looked a lot more clean, in my opinion. I mean, it definitely makes him look more badass once he Dokkan Awakened, but I don't know, I feel like the art design was definitely nicer, in my opinion. It's probably, a lot has to probably do with nostalgia too, just because of, you know, how old that unit is and how long it actually evaded me for a while until I actually got a copy of him. So I don't know, I guess a lot of things do factor in with that, not just, you know, the art design itself, but personally I think, yeah, the base form definitely looks better than the Dokkan Awakened version, and it seems to apply for most cases, but for a lot of cases, and it makes sense as to why that is, because if you think about it, the base form card art has to be very appealing for people to want to pull on it. You know what I mean? Like, the Dokkan Awakened version can definitely look badass or nice or nicer, you know, whatever the case is. But you definitely want to draw the attention of, you know, the player base in terms of the base form, because, you know, if you reserve a badass artwork for the Dokkan Awakened version and don't really focus on the base form, yeah, it could potentially affect players', you know, mentality as to going into the banners. I mean, it's really a psychological and marketing component of it. I mean, you know, you're gonna be drawn attention to how things look. I mean, that's the bottom line. So, I know I got off on a little tangent there, but I thought it was worthwhile mentioning that because it is an interesting concept of how our brain actually works. You know what I mean? So this is a little bit of a different variation that you've been seeing. This includes different units within the Realm of Gods team. So you've got the Super Saiyan Blue Evolution Vegeta instead of the Strength Super Saiyan Blue Vegeta that you saw previously. You do see other units like the Transforming Goku unit as well. You could certainly create a team with the Transforming Goku as lead and create a super type team that way too. That's certainly an option. You've got other units like the Intelligence version of Goku, and then you've got LR Vegito Blue also in here, but just kind of provide a variety on how to potentially use teams. Obviously the previous setup is most ideal for the Agility Goku unit, but you don't necessarily prioritize one unit over the other, you know what I mean? So more or less you focus on the balance and harmony of the team itself versus just a heavy focus on one unit. So in that regard, that's kind of what the format is, just switching things up a little bit. We'll have to see, by the way, how the Transforming Rose or Goku Black unit is gonna fit into teams like this. Now, the name should be different, but I think it's going to replace, not that it's that much relevant nowadays, but the physical version of Goku Black. I'm guessing it's going to, the new transforming version is going to have the same name, so that's probably going to be the only restriction, but at least you can link the strength version of Super Saiyan Rose, as well as the, I believe the LR version has, you know, LR Goku Black and Zamasu, so hopefully that's not too bad there. But again, this is a showcase for the Agility Goku unit, so hopefully you enjoyed it. As always, certainly appreciate you watching.